What Chapel Prophetic Confirmation 2013.
Fellow South Africans, our beloved Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela, the founding president of our democratic nation, has departed. He passed on peacefully in the company of his family around 2050 on the 5th of December 2013. He is now resting. He is now at peace. Our nation has lost its greatest son. Our people have lost a father. Although we knew that this day would come, nothing can diminish our sense of a profound and enduring loss. His tireless struggle for freedom and him the respect of the world. His humility, his compassion, and his humanity and him their love. Our thoughts and prayers are with the Mandela family. To them we owe a debt of gratitude. They have sacrificed much and endured much so that our people could be free. Our thoughts are with his wife, Mrs. Graça Machel, his former wife, Miss Winnie Madikizela Mandela, with his children, his grandchildren, his great-grandchildren, and the entire family. Our thoughts are with his friends, comrades, and colleagues who fought alongside Madiba over the course of a lifetime of struggle. Do it again, do it
again. As I'm talking to you, there are two stars in Nigeria that are going. They are not going to survive. Yeah. I'm seeing other ones in Western world, but I don't want to mention names.
At his trial in 1964, Nelson Mandela closed his statement from the dock saying, "I have fought against white domination, and I have fought against black domination. I have cherished the ideal of a democratic and free society in which all persons live together in harmony and with equal opportunities. It is an ideal which I hope to live for and to achieve. But if needs be, it is an ideal for which I am prepared to die." And Nelson Mandela lived for that ideal, and he made it real. He achieved more than could be expected of any man. And today he's gone home. And we've lost one of the most influential, courageous, and profoundly good human beings that any of us will share time with on this earth. He no longer belongs to us. He belongs to the ages. Through his fierce dignity and unbending will to sacrifice his own freedom for the freedom of others, Madiba transformed South Africa and moved all of us. His journey from a prisoner to a president embodied the promise that human beings and countries can change for the better. His commitment to transfer power and reconcile with those who jailed him set an example that all humanity should aspire to, whether in the lives of nations or our own personal lives. And the fact that he did it all with grace and good humor and an ability to acknowledge his own imperfections only makes the man that much more remarkable. As he once said, I'm not a saint unless you think of a saint as a sinner who keeps on trying. I am one of the countless millions who drew inspiration from Nelson Mandela's life. My very first political action, the first thing I ever did that involved an issue or a policy or politics, was a protest against apartheid. I would study his words and his writings. The day he was released from prison gave me a sense of what human beings can do when they're guided by their hopes and not by their fears. And like so many around the globe, I cannot fully imagine my own life without the example that Nelson Mandela set. And so long as I live, I will do what I can to learn from him. To Gresham Michel and his family, Michel and I extend our deepest sympathy and gratitude for sharing this extraordinary man with us. His life's work meant long days away from those who loved him most, and I only hope that the time spent with him these last few weeks brought peace and comfort to his family. To the people of South Africa, we draw strength from the example of renewal and reconciliation and resilience that you made real. A free South Africa at peace with itself. That's an example to the world. And that's Madiba's legacy to the nation that he loved. We will not likely see the likes of Nelson Mandela again. So it falls to us as best we can to forward the example that he set, to make decisions guided not by hate but by love, to never discount the difference that one person can make, to strive for a future that is worthy of his sacrifice. For now, let us pause and give thanks for the fact that Nelson Mandela lived, a man who took history in his hands and bent the arc of the moral universe towards justice. May God bless his memory and keep him in peace.
South Africans are contemplating a future without Nelson Mandela after the death of the country's first black president who led the struggle against apartheid. The day has seen more and more people gathering at the family home in Johannesburg, where he died aged 95 in the company of his family after a long illness.
No, it's a sad day in South Africa, I must say. We've lost a great role model. But I think the greatest thing is that at least his legacy, you know, will live on.
He spent 27 years in prison. Just to give to the people of South Africa what freedom means.
It's a pretty sad day. I mean, we're lucky to be in an era where there's been such a great man. You had so much forgiveness and compassion.
In Cape Town, a service of remembrance was led by Archbishop Desmond Tutu, a friend of Mandela and a fellow Nobel Prize winner. All over South Africa and beyond, people have been gathering to celebrate the life of the man who oversaw the end of white minority rule and symbolized reconciliation and peaceful coexistence. From prisoner under apartheid to world statesman, Mandela's death enables South Africans to take stock of the decades of momentous change he did so much to bring about.